Hello, and thank you for dropping into my video. So today's video, I'm going to let you know how you can prepare for Disney if you're a first time visitor, or if you have been to Disney before and it just didn't work out for you. So if you're interested in finding out how, stay tuned. So if you haven't checked out my part one, you can check on that video and I'll just post a link here. Part one discusses some things that you can that can save you money if you're planning on going to Disney. And yeah, just some tips, and I hope that they're helpful for you. Recently, my family and I went to Disney. We went to Magic Kingdom and Animal Kingdom. And some of the things that were helpful to prepare for is just knowing these things before you actually go. So one of the things that you want to know is that you will pay for parking, and parking at the park is $25 a day depending on the type of parking that you choose. Now you can choose for the preferred parking, which I believe is $50, but if you decide to leave the parks, you can come back, just show them your receipt, and you don't have to pay again. So that's the good thing. Prepare to park longer distances if you do not get the preferred parking. And also prepare for entering the park. There are options at the Magic Kingdom park, whether you can take decide to take the train or the boat. If you decide to take the boat over, you don't have to wear a mask, but they are still requiring a mask if you decide to take the train. So those are some things that you want to make sure that you know before going. Also, when you enter the park, make sure that you pick up a map. That's a good thing. Right away, pick up a map, because this is going to help you as you go through the park. It's going to help you to map out right away. And although it may seem like it's going to take some time, which it probably will depending on how big your group is, to know exactly where you're going to go, it's going to save you time in the long run, and it's going to help you better prepare to ride more rides than you would if you didn't do so. So you're going to grab your map, and it comes in different languages, and you're just going to go through the park, and those rides that you're interested in, go ahead and circle them, and just map. It gives you a visual of where these things are. It's also very helpful. Download the Disney app before you even go. The Disney app is going to help you with the times, the wait times. It's going to tell you different restaurants and those restaurants that are in your price range. It gives you different visuals of those restaurants as well. And it kind of helps you plan, like, just your plan for the day. It's a scheduler. It's also going to help you is when you're purchasing your tickets, purchase a lightning pass. For me and my family, we have a little one. And even if you don't have a little one, standing in line at Disney can be exhausting, okay? Because some of the lines can go over an hour and you just don't know. So even though it's an extra cost, $15 a person per day, if you're over the age of two, it was well worth it. And so what that does is that you can reserve a ride ahead of time, but you can only reserve one ride at a time. I think there's still an option. It used to be called Fast Pass, where you can reserve up to three rides at the time, but you can only reserve one ride at a time, but up to three rides per visit is what I wanted to say. But with the Lightning Pass is what they offer now, you can reserve as many as you can, you know, except they have to be one at a time. Once you've written on that one or canceled it, then you can reserve another. But it's very helpful in knowing how much time is going to take for you to come back to that ride. So what it does is it will block a time and tell you what time that you need to return to the ride to ride. And so you don't have to wait in line that long. In the meantime, you can ride on other things that may be shorter times. You can just view the park and do other things and then return back when it's that time. So it does save you time. I do wish that you can reserve more at one time, because some rides, once you're riding on that one, it does take, you know, another ride, maybe another 100-something minutes, and you have to like find things to do in between. But once again, if you have a big family, it may not be a big deal. You can eat in between or, you know, do something. You need restroom breaks. You never know. So those are good options. Another thing that is good, if you're having a birthday or if you are, if you're a first time visitor, visit one of the gift shops. It doesn't matter which one it is now. You can go into a gift shop, let them know that it's your birthday or you're a first time visitor, and they'll give you a little pin. And the pin will, you know, let people know that you are a first time visitor. It's possible that they may, you know, you may get special treatment because you have a pin saying, you know, first visitor or birthday or something like that. So that's really nice. One of the other things that you want to do, prepare for rain. So this is one of the things that we did not do. I knew it was going to rain, but I didn't think it would rain like all day. So once we went to the Animal Kingdom, it was like rain, stop, rain, stop, rain, stop. And by the end of the park, we were soaked. When you visit Disney, if you have a young one, then you'll have a stroller. And there are areas where you can park that stroller. However, they're not covered. So if you can go on Amazon or somewhere and find a cover for your stroller, that would be the best investment that you can make, okay, when visiting Disney. Because like walk out and everything was just soaking wet, and then in between time, it wouldn't dry because it was cloudy. And so that would be very helpful. Also wear shoes that are comfortable and shoes that are that will last in rain, because that's another thing. Feet were soaked. It was just, I don't know. And wear a poncho. If you can bring a poncho, is also a great option. So make sure that you prepare for rain, the elements, and also bring a hat with a visor. Is great because it's going to be hot and you want to be protected. Also sunscreen to protect the skin. So those are some things that wish we would have done and remembered, but you know, I'm sharing with you guys because it's very important. Another thing that you may want to do before you go to Disney, and this is something that I found when I visit different cities, there's always a Walmart in the area that has things that are in relation to what is the theme of the city, you know. So like if you're at a beach, there are Walmarts that have like a lot of things, beachwear and things like that. Visit a Walmart that's nearby and it will save you money on paraphernalia. Like you can buy Disney ears, lots of hats, lots of shirts and things like that, you know, things that you would normally buy at Disney that costs like $30 for like a pair of ears, you can purchase for like $12 at a Walmart. So make sure you check out Walmart first if you want to save some money before going into the park and spending like crazy amounts of money on paraphernalia. So that's a good tip. Also, if you have transportation, it's good to stop at Walmart as well and get like things that you need for the park, water and snacks and things like that. It's gonna save you money as well. Another tip that I wanted to share was be prepared to stand in long lines. And yes, you may have the Lightning Pass and things like that, but there's gonna be a lot of walking, there's gonna be a lot of standing, there's gonna be just a lot of being on your feet. So be prepared, make sure that your shoes are very comfortable for walking long distances and things like that. Also, the gas prices have gone up. So you wanna make sure that your hotel is close to the park, and don't, you know, waste time and gas traveling a lot. If you can find something close, do so. It'll save you money as well. Also, visiting the park this time, we went to Disney Springs, which was a nice little shopping area related to Disney, of course. So there was a lot of things that could be purchased representing the 50th anniversary of Disney. And it was just a nice park with restaurants and things like that, different stores. I thought it was a great scenery. So that's something that you may want to visit if you're passing the time away. And you know, there's also the Rainforest Cafes, which are nice. Just, you know, something to do if you have like some time in between visiting the park. So when you enter the park, if you choose to ride the boat or if you choose to ride the train option requires you to wear a mask. However, once you're in the park, no one asks you for a mask. So I kind of thought that was weird, but it's true. No one asks for a mask. If you want to wear a mask, it's fine. If you don't, it's okay. So just be mindful of that. And that includes in the rides, that includes outside and restaurants and things like that. Here's one of the items that I did not think that I would do because my daughter is under two. And so I thought that once I went to the park that we would stay for like a few hours, come to the park once it was opening and leave like in the middle of the day and return in the evening. But it didn't happen that way. And the reason was because it just seemed like it was just a lot of work to leave the park and come back to the park. It would cut out a lot of time. So instead we decided to stay at the park and give her some times to take naps because we just basically worked on her time. If she wanted to take a nap, fine. We just planned around that, took a break basically, let her take her nap, and then continue on with whatever we were going to ride on and things like that. So if you can't leave the park, I think it's perfectly fine. I think once you're in the park, you'll realize or understand what is best for you and your family. And if you can't leave the park, it's fine. It's really supposed to be fun for the whole family. So make it a vacation, make it, you know, interesting for all, and just don't, you know, it just leave room for anything to happen basically. What I do like about the area of Orlando is things are very mapped out on the roadway. There's signs and everything leading to the park. So it gives you good visuals. It looks very clean as far as there's a lot of shopping centers and things like that. So if you're interested in also doing shopping, that's something that there are different areas really close, lots of restaurants and things like that. So I think you really enjoy it. But yeah, I think that's pretty much all for this video. And I hope that I shared enough with you guys that gives you an idea of some of the things that you can prepare for when you're going to Disney. Kind of open your eyes to some things that you may not have thought about. And yeah, definitely leave a comment below if there's anything that I missed and that you would like to share. And that could be helpful to someone else. And I thank you guys for watching my video. And I will see you on the next one. Bye.